Hello students, today we will be discussing a new topic which is Clichés and Redundancy. You will find this topic in Unit 4 of Professional English. Cliché is a French word. Clichés are expressions that were once new and fresh, but with their overuse they have now become stale, they have now become less effective, or they have even lost their original meaning. For example, think outside the box. It must have been a fresh and an innovative expression at some point in time, but today it is considered as a cliché, and it does not make such an impact when used in everyday or formal or technical writing. Similarly, we have another expression like better safe than sorry. This expression also has lost its impact over time and has become stale, which means it's no more fresh. Clichés are considered to be bad because for formal writing, because they make the writer look lazy and like somebody who does not have new words or expressions to communicate his message. Let's look at a few examples. Example number one says, we are as sick as a parrot with the result. As sick as a parrot is a cliché expression, which means to be extremely disappointed. You might not have come across this phrase because in spoken English, where English is spoken as second language, it's not very common. But in written documents like novels, newspapers, magazines or other literary works, it's very common. So we can rewrite it as we are extremely disappointed with the result. It means the same thing. Both the sentences convey the same meaning. But in the second one, we have successfully avoided using a cliché expression. Example number two, at the end of the day, I made a difference in the world. At the end of the day, this is a cliché expression which is widely used, in fact, overused. It means ultimately, it means finally. So we can rephrase a sentence and we can write, ultimately, I can say, I made a difference in the world, or finally, I can say I made a difference in the world without changing the meaning of the sentence. Similarly, there are a lot of cliché expressions associated with different things, like the following which are associated with time. For example, if I say the ambulance arrived in the nick of time. In the nick of time is another cliché expression which means just in time, or just before something bad could have happened. So I can rewrite the sentence as the ambulance arrived just in time. So I did not use the phrase in the nick of time, and I conveyed the same message but by avoiding a cliché expression. Similarly, other expressions like at the speed of light, which means very quickly. Another type of cliché is describe people. Like if I had to say Ram is as brave as a lion. So instead of saying that, I can simply say Ram is a very brave person. Or instead of saying my grandmother is 89 years old, but she is as fit as a fiddle. As fit as a fiddle is a cliché expression which means to be in a very good health, to be in a very good shape. So we can say my grandmother is 89 years old, but she is in a good shape, or she is in a good health. There are other clichés that describe emotions. Like while consoling somebody who is hurt, we say, don't be sad, time will heal all wounds. Time heals all wounds is a very famous cliché expression, which means with time things get better. So instead of saying don't be sad, time will heal all wounds, we can simply say don't be sad, with time things will get better, or with time things will be fine. So there are a lot of reasons why clichés should be avoided in technical communication. Like it can be a barrier to communication and clear expressions, because clichés are often specific to languages and even cultures, and they may be a communication barrier to international readers. It can show a lack of original thought. It can make a writer appear unimaginative and lazy. Because clichés are considered as shortcuts and they reflect low quality. Clichés can be vague and irrelevant. Why so? Because a lot of times clichés are not used correctly or they rarely make sense. Because some of them have been repeated for so many years that the original reference is now archaic. It's now irrelevant. Also, it makes the discourse predictable and thus boring. So, it makes the text predictable. You know what is coming up next. That makes the text, that makes the document boring. Moving on to redundancy. Redundancy is unnecessary repetition of an idea or words or phrases. It is also known as wordiness in simple language. So when we use extra and needless words in our writing, they just make the text longer and nothing else. Because quality is not determined with the number of words we use to communicate our message. So redundant expressions only make the writing longer and not better. It is that part of the message that can be eliminated without losing any meaning or information. So, redundant phrases, because they are additional words to the sentence, therefore even if we remove them, we do not lose any meaning or information. Using redundant expressions in communication is like beating around the bush, which means repeating the same thing again and again. For example, you killed a fly and then you again killed the same fly. It does not change anything because the fly was dead at the first place only. Redundancy is like that only. It's like repeating the unnecessary things. Here are a few examples of redundancy. The problems first began when Gary lost his job. In the revised sentence, we can see that we dropped the word first and we rewrote the sentence as the problems began when Gary lost his job, because began already indicates starting of something for the first time. Therefore, we can remove the word first. Sam, Tom and Susie gathered together around the fire. Gathered together. So in the revised sentence, we write as Sam, Tom and Susie gathered around the fire. Why so? Because to gather already means to come together. So saying gather together is nothing but repetition. In the third sentence, he reversed the car back down the driveway. Do you ever reverse your car in front? No. So reverse itself means going back. So putting the word back in the sentence is just making the sentence superfluous. It's just putting in extra words in the sentence without actually adding anything to the meaning of the sentence, which means we can rewrite the sentence as he reversed the car down the driveway, and it conveys exactly the same meaning as the first sentence. So here are a few more examples of redundant phrases, like during the course of. It just means during. So instead of using four words, we can just use one word, which is during. For example, at the present time I am pursuing BTech. I can say the same thing as currently I am pursuing BTech. So again, instead of using four words to mean currently or presently, I just used one word, which is currently I am pursuing BTech. Similarly, there are other examples like compile together. This is just a redundant phrase. So we can write it as compile, because compiling already means that to bring a lot of things together. Now, avoiding redundancies. It is necessary to avoid redundancy because it serves as a barrier to effective communication in various ways. The reasons to avoid redundancies are, first of all, getting rid of unnecessary words makes your writing clearer and more effective. Removing unnecessary words makes the text more clear. It makes the text more understandable. It affects the conciseness or brevity of the document. So it makes a text more precise but comprehensive, which means less words to convey better meaning, less words to convey maximum information. Third, redundant words and phrases make the sentence sound repetitive. Repeating the same thing over and over makes the reader like annoyed. Just like in the fourth point, it tends to interrupt the flow of writing, causing the reader to become distracted, to become annoyed or irritated. And finally, displays an amateur quality of writing, which means it shows as if the writer is not a skilled writer. He does not possess good skills in writing. So that's all about cliches and redundancy. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can post it in the comment box. We would be glad to help. Thank you. Happy learning.